If you're looking to boost your immune system, if you're looking for something highly nutritious, I think this is it. You're looking at dandelion, just simple dandelion leaves, dandelion plant, which is loaded at the moment with vitamins, minerals, fiber, and lots of highly nutritious stuff from root to the flower. So you can use leaves, flowers and roots, which would be packed with all these vitamins and minerals. If you are looking at the moment to get some magnesium, iron, calcium or potassium, you can find it now in these dandelion leaves. So you don't really have to rush or go to the pharmacy, because this is the real stuff and the pharmacy can't really offer you real stuff. This is excellent source of vitamin A, C, K or folate, and even some little vitamin B. But what's the most interesting, I think, is that the whole plant is medicinal and edible from its root to the bloom, and it's got potent antioxidants, high level of antioxidant beta carotene, and as far as I know, it's rich in antioxidant, which is called something like polyphenols, it's some kind of category, antioxidant category, which the richest or the highest concentration would be in the blooms, but still you would be able to find it in its leaves and in the roots. If you want to fight, yes, if you want to fight inflammation, or, yeah, you're right, yeah, dandelions, yummy. If you want to fight inflammation, or if you want to stay healthy with your digestion and treat constipation, you should really be consuming these dandelion leaves. It's interesting that it can lower your blood sugars, and you can control your blood sugars this way, or you can reduce cholesterol levels. If you read holistic medicine, you can find out that it will detoxify certain organs. Definitely liver. Yes, dandelions. Some pancreatic tissues and colon as well. It's not actually bad to eat it in its salad, in a salad form. It's quite tasty. What I did is I gathered some dandelion leaves, I washed them, I even didn't chop them, and I just added my sprouts that I have. I added grapefruit just to make it more juicy. You can use olive oil or any kind of oil that you like using. I added some dandelion blossom oil. Yummy, it's yummy. Look. Yum, yum, yum. He will have salad, nice salad. He will like it. And what we add is just some seeds. I like black sesame seeds or any kind of wild seeds if you have. And some juice from, I don't know, lemon or apple cider vinegar. And it's beautiful, beautiful salad to eat. I will dry blossoms for teas, or you can use them in salve, pain relieving salve for your muscles. Or if you have some ache in your stomach, this is nice tea. Yay, blossoms. Nice blossoms, dandelion blossoms. Look at them. We'll dry them? Will we dry them? Yeah, we will dry them. And we will make some tea, will we? Oh, yeah. We'll make some tea. So I'm making oil from those blossoms, and I'm using them in salves, also in the creams. It's perfect part in your salve. It will release the pain in your muscles. Also, as I said, I'm drying them and storing them in the glass jars for tea. Yes, it's nice tea for your tummy. Very nice tea for your tummy. Some people will fry them. You can eat them in your salad. See, it's got many uses. I would really go after the roots of these dandelions now, because it's springtime, or in late fall, because few studies, I know, done on the animals, but few studies shown that it can help to fight cancer. So dandelion root can slow down the growth of dramatically can slow down the growth of the cancer cells in your liver or colon or pancreatic tissue. So it can perfectly treat your inner organs, because all your inner organs actually love bitter taste, and this is what dandelion leaf can provide you with. Yes, what you can do is actually, if you can't get over this bitter taste of dandelion root, you can ferment it. So, for example, what I do is, I dig dandelion root, I will shred it, and I will ferment it with cabbage in the sauerkraut way. So exactly in the way as you were fermenting your kraut, your cabbage, sauerkraut, you will just add shredded root. This way, your result will be savory taste. So you can eat dandelion root in its raw form. Yes, you can eat dandelion root in its raw form when it's fermented. If it was not fermented, it's really bitter, but you can get over this bitter taste once you're fighting the cancer. You can forget about the bitter taste. You can just drink it. You can juice the root. You can juice the root and you can consume it if you want to get something, some real medicine to help you to fight the cancer. So that's what I do. I will dig them, I will dry them, and will either use them, the roots, I'm talking about the roots, we'll use them for teas, medicinal teas, or I can make the coffee with the roots if you roast them. But I would prefer making tincture from the root of the dandelion. I will add some leaves as well for your sluggish liver and for all your inner organs. And as I said, I will keep few fresh roots that I will ferment along with cabbage in the sauerkraut way. So this way you can consume it in its raw way. I did it a couple of times and the root really tastes soury, very lemony, like sauerkraut. Yes, so that's dandelion leaves. It's a great medicine and it's nice food. And we like it. Do we, Linda? Do you like dandelion leaves? Yes! She said yes, she loves it. And she's recommending the same for everyone. Cheers!